जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी,
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 जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी,
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 यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी,
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी।
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम राम
कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे
जय कृष्ण बलराम कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम
जय कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम
जय गौरानिताय जय गौरानिताय गौरानिताय जय गौरानिताय
जय गौरानिताय जय गौरानिताय गौरानिताय जय गौरानिताय
जय जय प्रभुपा
जय जय
ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। भगवद गीता चैप्टर 18 वर्स नंबर 26। मुक्त संगो नहं वादी धृत्युत्साह समन्वितः सिद्ध्य सिद्ध्योर निर्विकारः कर्ता सात्विक उच्यते। द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्स इज द वर्कर हु इज फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल मटेरियल अटैचमेंट्स एंड फॉल्स ईगो हु इज एंथुसियास्टिक एंड रेजोल्यूट एंड हु इज इनडिफरेंट टू सक्सेस और फेलियर इज अ वर्कर इन द मोड ऑफ गुडनेस। So beginning from this verse, Krishna describes different types of workers. Worker in the mode of goodness, worker in the mode of passion, worker in the mode of ignorance. Karta, worker is, the Sanskrit word is karta, the doer, person who performs the activity or action. See the characteristics of the person who works in the mode of goodness. Worker in the mode of goodness. First of all, such a person is above false ego and pride. This is a characteristic of the mode of goodness, above false ego and pride. And he has no expectations for the result of the work. But he is always enthusiastic till the work is completed. Maintains that enthusiasm for doing the work very nicely till the work is completed. And he does not worry about the distress that he has to undergo for doing the work. If there is some difficulty or some distress, he doesn't mind that. He is always enthusiastic. He does not care for success or failure because that is left to the Supreme Lord. The result of any activity that we perform in this world is not in our hands. Result is in the hands of the Supreme Lord Krishna. It is Krishna only who awards the result of every activity to every person in this world. That's a fact. So, a worker in the mode of goodness is in knowledge. Therefore, he knows, result is not in my hand. But what is in my hand? I can be enthusiastic. I can work without false ego, without pride. I can be very, very determined to complete the work nicely. So these characteristics are the characteristics of a worker in this mode of goodness. Now, why this description about worker in the mode of goodness? Because if somebody works in goodness, then they are elevating themselves to a higher platform of existence in this world. Generally, pious people who follow the Shastra, who are careful to avoid sinful activities, they elevate themselves to a higher situation. Of course, somebody who is not performing bhakti yoga, their elevation is very gradual. Whereas bhakti yoga ensures that the elevation is the fastest, the immediate elevation to the higher status. More importantly, it's bhakti yoga only that enables one to come out of the clutches of Maya, the clutches of the three modes of material nature, only by Bhakti Yoga. There is no other way to come out of the clutches of Maya or the material energy. Bhagavad Gita, chapter 18, text number 27. Ragi karma phala prepsu, lubdho himsatmako ashuchihi, harsha shokanvita karta, rajasa parikirtitaha. That worker who is attached to the fruits of his labor and who passionately wants to enjoy them, who is greedy, envious, and impure, and moved by happiness and distress, is a worker in the mode of passion. Unlike the worker in the mode of goodness, the worker in the mode of passion is very much attached to the fruits. He wants always success, and for what purpose does he want success in the work? He wants to enjoy the results himself, and he is very passionate about it, enjoying the results himself. He is greedy. Greed means, if I have so much wealth, I want more. Then if I get more wealth, then I want even more wealth. And if I get even more wealth, I want even much, much, much more than that. So there is no end to how much a person may desire to possess or get if a person is greedy. So greed is very dangerous. In the later chapter, it will be described. We are in the 18th chapter. It is already described in the 16th chapter. Greed is one of the gateways to hell. That's a fact. If one cannot control greed, then such a person will definitely end up in hellish life. So greed is very dangerous. Whereas those who are workers in the mode of passion, they're generally very greedy. They are envious because they're always looking at others who are little better off than them, and they become envious of such a person. Why should we be envious of somebody else? Because everybody is placed according to their past activity in the proper body, in the proper situation, in a proper association, etc. So, previous life, whatever activities I had done, I am now placed in a particular body, in a particular circumstance, etc. Now, if I do pious activities or good activities now, in my future, I will have nice facilities. So, the very culture always encourages everyone to do their duty very nicely so that they're guaranteed to get elevation to the higher status by the Supreme Lord, because they are engaged in their duty properly according to scriptural directions. Now, those who are passionate, worker in the mode of passion, is impure. So, Srila Prabhupada explains, why is the person attached to the result? Because of his attachment for materialism. What is attachment for materialism? They are attached to their home, their family, their wife, their children. And such people generally do not desire higher elevation of life. They're simply concerned with making this world as comfortable a place as possible. That's why they're greedy. They want to make it as comfortable as possible. And they always are under the impression that whatever situation they achieve by hard work, they think that is permanent situation. There is no permanence in this material world. everything is lost at the time of death. So, such passionate people, they are envious of others because they are prepared to do anything wrong for sense enjoyment. Therefore, they are unclean. They are described as unclean. Ashuchihi, they are unclean. And they do not care whether the earning is pure or impure. Pure means one properly follows the rules and regulations for working, and they don't get into sinful reactions. Whereas those who don't bother so much about the principles of the scriptures, they unhesitatingly perform sinful activities and suffer the consequences. So a person who is in a mode of passion, he does not care for pure or impure ways of earning. And a person in the mode of passion, he is happy when he is successful in this endeavor, and he is very unhappy and morose if he is not successful in his endeavor. So they are affected by success or failure. Bhagavad Gita, chapter 18, verse number 28. Ayukta prakrita sthabdaha shatho naishkritiko lasaha vishadi dirgha sutricha karta tamasa uchyate. The previous two verses describe sattvik karta and rajasik karta. Now, karta tamasa uchyate, tamasik karta. First point is engaged in work against the injection of scripture, because scriptures are giving human beings certain rules which they have to follow, but some people don't care for the scriptures without understanding the importance of following Shastra. There are some people who neglect or ignore, don't bother to find out what is right, what is the proper way of doing something. So such people, they don't care, and invariably they end up doing something against the Shastra. They are materialistic. Such people cannot have a higher understanding at all. That's why they are very materialistic. Obstinate, they are very stubborn. They won't listen to others. They don't care for, not they don't care, they don't listen to others. They always think they are right. And cheating, they want to cheat. Mode of ignorance is such that it will influence them to cheat others. Always cunning. They want to take undue advantage of others. And expert in insulting others. Insulting others because they think they are very superior. So they want to look down upon others. So they cheat others. Such a person is also lazy. That means he doesn't want to work really. He tries to escape work. Always morose. Morose means he's always dull, or he's always sad, always very unclean. And another characteristic is procrastinating. That means always postponing doing some work. If some work takes 1 hour, they will drag and drag and drag and make it spread over several weeks and months and years also. So this is the characteristic of a person in the mode of ignorance. I'll take some questions now. Shall we chew tulsi leaves or swallow? According to some beliefs, mercury inside tulsi leaves harms our teeth. I do not know about mercury inside tulsi leaf, But there is nothing wrong if we chew tulsi leaves. There is nothing wrong. And swallowing is difficult. Swallowing tulsi leaves is difficult. So chew tulsi leaves and take. What is the difference between a man working very hard in the mode of passion and a man working hard in the mode of ignorance? Is a person in mode of passion also spiritually lazy? So first question, what is the difference between a person working hard in the mode of passion, working hard in the mode of ignorance? See, a person in the mode of passion, we can understand, works hard. A person in the mode of ignorance is a lazy fellow. Characteristic of the mode of ignorance is laziness. So a person in the mode of ignorance doesn't work hard. Will not work hard. Be lazy. If at all somebody is very determined to do something but is in a mode of ignorance, then such a person will try to avoid working. He will try to avoid working. Instead of working, somehow they will manage by talking or by hiding or by making an excuse why they cannot do some work, etc., etc. So that is people who are in the mode of ignorance, they are different from the people in the mode of working in the mode of passion. Next part of the question is a person in the mode of passion also spiritually lazy? Now, spiritually lazy, spiritually active, there is no such thing. Of course, people in the mode of passion and ignorance neglect spiritual scriptural injunction. That's a fact. So they miss out on the directions of the scriptures. Next question. How to increase sadhana cheshta so that we may shift from bhajana kriya to nishtha stage? There are so many different ways in which we can increase, we can get more inspiration to do our sadhana. Sadhana means practicing bhakti yoga. We can get inspiration from so many sources. To accelerate our progress, we have to become very, very determined to chant nicely, to perform devotional service very nicely. Like that, we have to strive to actually reach the higher, attain the higher stages of practice of bhakti. Nishtha stage is a stage where we are fixed up in devotional service. So that happens after sufficient anartha nivritti takes place. Means our heart becomes cleansed of all material contamination, almost all material contamination. Then we can get fixed up in devotional service. Is working on spiritual platform and working mode of goodness same? No, they're not the same. Working in mode of goodness is on the material platform, though goodness is superior to passion and ignorance. But working on the mode of goodness, on the platform mode of goodness, is binding us. It gives us a better next life, materially better. But it doesn't result in, by itself, mode of goodness does not result in liberation or freedom from material bondage. No, that's not possible. How can a person change who is in ignorance and avoid procrastination? Now, any person who takes to Krishna consciousness is able to elevate himself or herself from any of the modes, platform, the mode of passion or ignorance or goodness, to the transcendental platform. That is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. So, everyone is advised to practice devotional service. Everyone is advised. So, of course, to nicely practice devotional service, one requires good association of like-minded devotees. So, by such association, one is able to get enthusiasm to do devotional service nicely. Next question. Is this understanding correct? When it is said that mode of goodness defeats other modes, mode of goodness is in effect exercising greater influence on the jiva than other two modes at that given time. Actually, it is not the degree of influence. Of course, there is a certain degree of influence of the gunas on the jiva's consciousness, yes. But then, more important to understand is that we are subject to influence as long as we are not situated on the spiritual platform, as long as we are not engaged in pure devotional service. We are subject to influence of the modes. So, mode of goodness defeats other two modes means there is a competition for the mode between the modes. Due to so many different factors, one becomes prominent and other two are less prominent at different times of the day, at different situations, in different atmosphere, environment. Just like, to give you an example, a liquor shop is always in the mode of ignorance. Forest is always in the mode of goodness. A city, always in the mode of passion. So atmosphere also matters. A person who is intoxicated and addicted to intoxication is always in the mode of ignorance. So this, then what is the meaning of competition between the modes? This is specifically with respect to the time of the day, to give an example, of course. Just like early morning hours, the mode of goodness dominates, in the sense that any person can get influenced by goodness early morning. But the same person in the afternoon is more subject to the mode of passion. Because passion defeats goodness and ignorance in the afternoon. And night, mode of ignorance is very dominating. Now, a person who is, even though maybe working in the night or working in the day or working in the afternoon or whatever, if the person is determined to do devotional service, then the time of the day does not matter. The situation in different places doesn't matter like that. So, the modes are interacting to actually bring about changes in material nature. But as far as we are concerned, we should always strive to be on the mode of goodness through the methods described in the scriptures. And for that, we have to take to devotional service essentially, because it immediately elevates us from any of the lower modes to the highest mode of transcendental realization. Is Mahakala referred to as Lord Shiva or Lord Vishnu? I do not know. I had to verify this. I don't know where the reference is for Mahakala. Next question. How does one not feel discouraged when Maya feels very strong despite trying to associate with devotees by coming to the temple once in a while? as an aspiring sadhaka. Now, Maya is very powerful, that's a fact. But if one is very determined to do devotional service and follows all the principles as far as you can follow and strictly avoid sinful activities, then Maya's power cannot act very strongly on the devotee who is trying to avoid Maya. So, to not become discouraged by Maya means to actually constantly engage in devotional service in varieties of ways. You may not be able to do the same type of devotional service always, but there are varieties of ways of engaging in devotional service. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, in the Nectar of Devotion, in the so many books explain that. What are the varieties of devotional service? Next question. Which is most important in Krishna consciousness, sadhana or service? Now, both are important. Sadhana and service, both are important. Because only sadhana means we become lazy to do service. And those who are doing only service all the time, they lose interest in sadhana, or they neglect sadhana, or they become lazy to do sadhana. So we should neither be lazy to do service nor be lazy to do sadhana. We have to do both. We have to balance it, actually, I would say. Morning time sadhana is ideal to do sadhana in the morning, early morning. Whereas service generally is done later in the day. Sometimes, of course, you may have service in the early morning also when it is some deity service or deity related service or some festival related service. So a devotee actually is ready to do any service for Krishna under superior guidance. So there is no question of sacrificing or replacing one with the other. No, both have to be done, sadhana and service. Shiva's advice to Narad Muni in Sri Sanat Kumar Samhita and Skanda Purana is that most Chintamani jewel of all mantras is Gopi Jana Vallabha Sharanam Prapadye. So why is this mantra not recommended? You see, there are specific mantras given to specific devotees, because that is their, that is the most suitable mantra for them. So you cannot generalize a mantra which is given to one particular devotee that is the best for everyone. No? In the Kali Santarana Upanishad, it is said, for everyone in Kali Yuga, the recommendation is Hare Krishna Mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And this is a universal mantra, as is recommended in the Kali Santarana Upanishad. How can a diseased or sick person perceive Krishna? Now, perceiving Krishna is not dependent on whether somebody is diseased or sick, his material condition. Perceiving Krishna requires purification of the heart or consciousness. So, to purify the consciousness is possible by spiritual practice like chanting Hare Krishna and other practices of Bhakti Yoga. And once the heart is cleansed, then one can actually apply the right process for method for perceiving Krishna. I'll stop here. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.